In this video, we want to talk about the origin of the ECG. The ECG is a representation, a recording of the electrical events of the heart throughout the cardiac cycle. We also want to be able to look at the ECG and infer the mechanical actions of the heart. Remember, the electrical activity of the heart is simply the stimulation for the mechanical actions, the contractions and relaxation cycles that occur in the atria and ventricles throughout a cardiac cycle. Now, at the top here, we have an anatomical representation of the heart showing these patterns of depolarization or repolarization that are going to be occurring. Below that, we have our ECG trace. You'll note that we have waves indicated by the red line and followed by segments. The segments are parts of what are called the isoelectric line. We talked about that previously in another figure. Now, the isoelectric line is when we have no dipole, no separation of charge, and we'll see that in just a moment. Below that, we have our atrial action potentials, followed by our ventricular action potentials. Now, certainly, there are millions of cells in the atria and probably hundreds of millions of cells in the ventricles. We're only showing you about 5 action potentials here from each, so it's just representative. But what we're trying to indicate is that the cardiomyocytes of the atria or the ventricles do not depolarize and repolarize in synchrony, right? Remember, we use that reference, that analogy of dominoes falling. You knock over a domino, they don't all fall simultaneously, they fall sequentially. And so we've got early cells that will depolarize and then later cells over here to the right. Remember, this is time on our x-axis. And so if our SA node fires, the first cells to depolarize in the atria, right, following those SA node cells, would be some of these atrial cells. And so these early left action potentials would occur. The action potentials over here on the right haven't occurred yet. And so if you look up here, right, we've got some yellow and some blue, some depolarized and some still at rest. That means we have a dipole, we get dipole current, and we get a wave. So the atrial depolarization phase generates the P wave. Well, very shortly thereafter, all of the cells are depolarized, right? And if all of the cells are depolarized, up here everything is yellow, then we have no dipole and we have no wave, right? We're now into an isoelectric segment of the ECG trace. This doesn't mean that nothing is happening. Remember, in the plateau phase, these atrial cardiomyocytes are actually contracting, generating pressure, and pushing blood into the ventricles. Then they would start to repolarize, again, non-sequentially. So we're going to end up with a dipole and a wave. However, you'll note our depolarization is now entering the ventricles as well. It's crossed over that AV bundle and it's entering the interventricular septum, as you can see here. And so now we've got both repolarization in the atria and depolarization in the ventricles. Well, we call the QRS complex, this waveform, ventricular depolarization. The reason for that is that there's 10 times as many ventricular cells as atrial cells. This is occurring in there, but the majority of this waveform is generated by ventricular cells depolarizing. We once again enter a plateau phase in those ventricular cardiomyocytes. No dipole, no wave, right? We're in an isoelectric segment here. Again, we have a contraction occurring, even though we're in an isoelectric phase here, because all of the cells are depolarized, right? When they're depolarized, they're contracting. In this case, we're pressurizing the blood to drive it out into the pulmonary and systemic circuits. That will be followed by asynchronous repolarization, which generates the T wave, right? Ventricular repolarization generates that T wave. That's followed by a period when the ventricular cells are all at rest. But if you look up, the atrial cells are also still already at rest. The SA node has not yet fired. So the heart is entirely at rest. This generates an isoelectric line, the TP segment, but this one differs from the previous two, the PR and the ST segments. During the PR segment, that was when atrial contraction occurred. During the ST segment, that's when the majority of ventricular contraction occurs. TP segment, the heart is completely in diastole. It's relaxed. It is filling with venous return, right? Blood coming back from the pulmonary and systemic circuits, filling the ventricles. And then our SA node is going to fire, and we're going to come right back around here to this P wave. Right? So it's important to keep in mind that the ECG certainly tells us about the electrical events, but those electrical events help us to predict the mechanical ones as well.